हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल विजार्ड ऑफ जियोलॉजी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस 8 एमसीक्यूज विद देयर एक्सप्लेनेशन। सो विदाउट डिले लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन वीडियो 11। ए कम्युनिटी ऑफ इंटर रिलेटेड ऑर्गेनिजम्स इनहेबिटिंग एन एरिया इज नोन एज व्हाट? बायोकोइनोस, बायोटॉफ, थेनाटोकोइनोस और नॉन ऑफ द एबोव? So the right answer is option A, that is bioconos. Okay, bioconos is the organisms which are inhabiting in a particular area. Okay, what is biotope? It is the inhabiting area. Okay, where these organisms living is called as biotope. Okay, this is inhabiting area. Okay, inhabiting area of the living organisms. What is thanatocoenos? Thanatocoenos is defined as the dead organisms which are found in a particular area. Okay, so the dead organisms means these were at a particular time deposited in marine or in any environment, so these organisms are now dead. Okay, red clay deposit is found in which biogeochemical zones? Littoral zone, neritic zone, bathyal zone, abyssal zone. So the right answer is option D, that is abyssal zone. Okay, red clay deposit is found in abyssal zone. So look here, littoral zone is defined as the area which is found in the between the high tide and low tide. Okay, sublittoral zone, this zone is found between the depth of 0 to 200 meter below the sea level. Similarly, bathyal zone is found 200 meter to 2000 meter below sea level. Abyssal zone is below 2000 meter. Generally, it is the depth range between 2000 to 6000. Okay, that is abyssal zone. Okay, and below this there comes hadal zone. Okay, this zone is complete dark. Okay, because sun ray does not penetrate through all these depths. Okay, which of the following is used to depict the flow pattern transition from laminar to turbulent? Okay, it is asking which number is used to depict the flow pattern from laminar to turbulent. Reynolds number, Freud number, both or none of the above? So the right answer is option A, that is Reynolds number. Okay, Reynolds number is used to depict the flow pattern, that is laminar, turbulent. Okay, what is Reynolds number formula? That is rho v d by mu. Okay, here rho is the density of fluid, v is velocity of the fluid. Okay, d is diameter of the flow pattern. Okay, diameter of the pipe, and mu is dynamic viscosity. Okay, dynamic viscosity. So Reynolds value ranges from, that is Reynolds value ranges from 500, then 500 to 5000, 500 to 2000, then above 2000. Okay, this is below 500. Here it is called as laminar flow. This is both and this is turbulent. Okay, similarly Freud number formula, F is equal to V by root over of GD. Okay, this is Freud number. Here V is the mean velocity, and g is the acceleration of gravity, and d is the depth of the hydraulic. Okay, so Fraud number value ranges from below 1, equal to 1, greater than 1. If this is below 1, then this is called as subcritical. Okay, this is critical, and above 1, this is called as supercritical. Okay, which of the following ionosphere layer of our atmosphere appears in daytime and vanishes at the sunset? So it is asking about the which layer of the ionosphere: D layer, E layer, E2 layer, F1 layer. So the right answer is option C, that is E2 layer. Okay, here the correct option is option C, that is E2 layer, which appears in the daytime and vanishes at the sunset. Okay, so you don't find this layer at night time. Look here, where is E2 layer? Here. Okay, this is E2 layer. Okay, this layer is found in the daytime, but it vanishes at night time. Okay, how this layer is produced in the daytime? This layer is produced in the daytime by the reaction of the ultraviolet rays and the oxygen. When the ultraviolet rays of the sun comes in contact with the O2 of in our atmosphere, then this E2 layer is created, because this is ionosphere zone. Okay, similarly, question comes, which layer is used for the radio wave transmission for the long area? Okay, F2 layer. F2 layer is used for long wave transmission of radio waves. Okay, because this wave is very stable, so the radio waves are transmitted from the earth surface to the layer, and this is reflected back to long area. Okay, so this layer is used for transmission of radio waves, that is F2 layer. These two both questions comes in general science questions also. Okay, arrange the following formation from old to young. Okay, that is in Younging direction: Umiya formation, Chari formation, Katral formation, Pancham formation. All these belong to which stratigraphy? Stratigraphy of Kutch. Okay, so the first is Pancham formation, then Chari formation, then Katral formation, then Umiya formation. That is DCBA. DBCA. That is option B is correct. Okay, arrange the following packing arrangements of grains in increasing order of their porosity. So you have to arrange the following packing arrangements of the grains in increasing order of their porosity. So when the grains are arranged, that is generally spherical grains are arranged in cubic shape. Okay, when these are packed in a cubic pattern, so what will be the its porosity? Okay, that is, if the spherical grains are packaged in a hexagonal system, then what will be its porosity? So it is asking to arrange in increasing order of their porosity. Okay, if these spherical grains are packaged in triclinic system, okay, then its porosity will be 26%. Okay, in tetragonal this is 30.2%, in hexagonal this is 39.5%, in cubic that is 47.6%. So highest porosity will be shown by cubic packing system. Okay, so the right answer will be DCBA, that is option C is the correct answer. Which of the following is called mushroom rock? Ear dunks, desert pavements, ventifex, pedestal rocks. So the right answer is option D, that is pedestal rocks. Okay, pedestal rocks are also known as mushroom rock. Okay, confusion arises. Look here. These structures are formed in parallel lines. So wind is flowing in this direction or in this direction. So these structures are parallel to the flow pattern of the wind direction. So these are called as ear dunks. Okay, ear dunks. This show a parallel pattern with respect to the wind flow. Okay, this is called as ventifex. Okay, what is ventifex? The polished surface of the rock are formed by the abrasion action of the wind. Okay, these are generally angular pattern. Okay, so you can see these are angular pattern of the rocks. These are formed by the abrasion, polishing by the wind action. Okay, this is desert pavement. Okay, what is desert pavement? When the fine soil are removed by the wind, okay, the coarse grains or rocks, pebbles are left in this area. So this is called as desert pavement. How are the main joints aligned to the cooling surface? Parallel at 45 degree, perpendicular or at 30 degree? It is asking if a rock surface, this is cooled, okay, then how will be its main joints? Generally the main joints will be aligned perpendicular. Okay, that is option C is correct. So these generally perpendicular. Okay, so these will either enter, this will crack the rock, either enter or minimum 2 to 3 centimeter below this surface. Okay, this cracks will develop. These will be perpendicular to the surface. Okay, main joints will be perpendicular to the surface. Okay, so thank you for watching our channel Wizard of Geology. We will see you in the next video soon. Okay.